Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to change your default port number in MySQL server as well as in MySQL workbench. So let's get started. So the first thing what you need to do is you need to find at what default port our MySQL server is running. So find it out. So we need to go to just search and I'll be typing MySQL, and here you'll be having an option called as MySQL command line client. Just open it and I will just zoom in a bit. It will be like quite similar to command prompt. So here you need to enter your password of your MySQL database. So I will just enter my password. So you'll be getting the MySQL shell opened over here. So in this, you need to run this particular command. It's going to be select space at port and a semicolon and hit enter. So this is the default port in which MySQL server or MySQL workbench is running currently. So we are going to change this particular thing now. So I will just now close it. And next thing what we need to do is we need to go to search again, and we will be searching for services this time. Okay, so just search for services and just open services, and in the services dialog box we need to go for MySQL. There will be a service named MySQL 80, so it is in M. Just click on it, it will be running by default. So if it is running, just stop the service. So it will take some time to stop the service. Yeah, so once the service is stopped, you'll be getting start the service. Just minimize it, don't close it. We will come back again to that. Yeah, so now the service is stopped. So now we need to go to and find the my.ini file. So this file will be present in, just come to this PC. You need to go to local disk C. And in the local disk C, you'll be having a folder named as program data. But the issue is that this particular folder will be hidden. So here you can see, right, that particular icon is slightly dull because this is a hidden file. So if you aren't able to see this particular folder, you need to go to view, and here you'll be having hidden items. So if you just uncheck it, I won't be having that particular folder. So what you need to do is you need to go to view and check this hidden items. So now that particular folder is visible. Okay, so program data, and here you'll be having MySQL. Click it. And inside MySQL, you'll be having this MySQL server and its version. Click it. And here you'll be having that particular my file, okay, where we will be making some changes to our port number. So before opening and making changes, we need to have prior permission to make edit and changes in this particular file. So for that, just click it and right click. And here you'll be having an option called as properties. And in this properties, in under security, we need to have all the privileges, okay? We need to be like have a tick mark for all the privileges, like the system user. So in my case, the user is going to be this user. So I've just selected it. And that particular user should have all these like privileges to full control, modify, read and write this particular file. So in case if you aren't having any of these controls, you need to just click on edit and select that particular user. And I need to just click on allow. Like if I uncheck this, and if it's unchecked, you need to just check it and click on apply and okay. So I'm going to do this for like the system user, the administrators, as I think system administrators and users, these three should have all the privileges for this particular file. Okay, so make a note of this, because if you don't do this particular stuff, you won't be able to edit this particular file. So this is an important thing. So once you have all the necessary permissions, just click on okay. So now we need to like open this particular file and make changes to our port number. So for doing that, exactly the same thing, select that particular file and right click it and click on open with. So here you'll be having an option to open with Notepad, but I would recommend you to do with Visual Studio Code or Notepad++. I will go with Visual Studio Code. So this is that particular my.ini file. So first what we need to do is we need to press on Ctrl+F keys. So for that we'll be getting this find option over here. And here just search for port. Just come down, and here we'll be having the default port as 3306. I will just change this to now 3310. Yeah, so you can type whatever the number you want, 4-digit number, and that particular number should be free, like that port should be free in your system. So I will go with this number 3310. So this is the first place, and again come down, and here will be also having another place to change it, that is a TCP/IP port. So I will also change this to 3310, and I think that's it, two places. Yeah, this is fine, this is another like Microsoft Server X protocol, this is fine, leave it. So yeah, now we are done, two places. I'm saving it again, and I'll just close this file and again go to services and start your MySQL service. So services, and I will just scroll to MySQL. Now here it is, I will just start the service. So once the service is started, again go to search and type MySQL and open the command line client. I will zoom in a bit, I will just enter my password. Yeah, so it's working fine now. So I will just type the same command, select at a port, and this time we need to get the port number as 3310 instead of 3306. That is the default port. If I hit enter, so I'm getting 3310, which means that we have successfully changed our port number in MySQL, and we need to make the exact same change in MySQL workbench as well. So in your MySQL workbench, you'll be having the local instance, like the instance of your connection. So just right click it, and you'll be having an option called as edit connection. Click it. And here you'll be having the port as 3306. Just enter the port that you have changed in that particular file. So I changed it to 3310. So after changing that, I will just click on close. That's it. I think it will get automatically saved there. So let me just check it as well. Yeah. So it's auto saved. Yeah, it's fine. So if I just now open it, and I will enter my password. Yeah, so everything is working on fine. My MySQL, like, it's working fine. I can do like select this thing. Yeah, everything works fine now. So this is how you change a port in MySQL server as well as MySQL workbench. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also run many other tutorials in C++, C, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, as well as MySQL queries, MongoDB. So do check the playlist of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.